Why did I come to Kiryat Arba? Why did the Jewish people come back to the land of Israel? Kiryat Arba, Hebron, is where it all began. This is where we read in the book of Genesis where Abraham purchased the first Jewish land here in the land of Israel.
The people of Judea and Samaria are settling the land and reclaiming their biblical heritage, but they are also helping people, saving children, and making a difference in the lives of so many.
We had nothing here, nothing, and today we have a place for children to come and read books.
And we have a kitchen here that gives food to the needy.
If we weren't here, these kids wouldn't have a place.
The children come to Derech Shalev when they have no other place to go.
This place is like a home for them. I am also like a mother for them.
We enable these people to feel safe, to come here, to be able to sleep through the night without shelling going on outside.
We bring them here and we try to give them all their needs.
And for some of them, this hot meal a day is sometimes their main meal.
Finally, she's able to sit down and talk to her father and her mother, and they're listening to her for the first time.
There was nothing. And today you can see a paradise here.
And we could not have done it without the help of the Christian Friends of Israeli Communities.
CFOIC Heartland has joined hands with the pioneers of Judea and Samaria and the refugees of Gush Katif to help them help themselves, to enable these amazing people to reach out to those in need.
In the summer of 2000, it was the onset of the Intifada, and there were multiple attacks on the roads. With the increase of terrorism, there was a dire need to save lives. We started from scratch. We were a group of doctors and medics. We had to seek equipment. We've had a wonderful relationship with the Christian Friends of Israeli Communities over the years. They visit us often, and every time they've come, they've been very forthcoming. We've received beds from them. We've received several other equipment. We've been given money towards the ultrasound machine. These funds have been very vital to our sustenance and existence.
Today I wake up in the morning and I go out, and instead of seeing the Mediterranean Sea, the palm trees, the beautiful, beautiful sights from my home, I see a parking lot and I see my other neighbors, but I know exactly where I live. It's a refugee camp. I see ship containers wherever I look. People have not been able to touch their belongings for the past 3 years.
In the meantime, the people are using their compensation, the compensation that they need to build their homes, a house, they are using for daily living. We had a lot of families that were in terrible need even for food, to put food on the table. We had a dear need of social workers who understood the population, who understood where we came from and what are really our needs. And this is why we are so grateful to CFOIC, to all these Christians all over the world who understood through you what the need is and gave assistance to that. And up until these days, these social workers are doing a beautiful work of keeping the communities together, keeping the families together.
We bought a doily here, I bought a doily there, I bought some placemats, some new placemats, I bought some curtains, put them up. I added a few bits and pieces of my own, and then I made it into a home.
Throughout this whole period of time, we realized after the uprooting, we realized that we appreciate two qualities, the capacity of listening and the capacity for consistency. And this is what we found both in CFOIC, the capacity of listening and understanding what our problems were, but also the consistency. For 3 years, you've been here to help us and to listen. And this is something very meaningful for us, and we're blessed by this relationship that we have with you.
My husband was stung by a wasp, and we didn't know that he was allergic. And he went into anaphylactic shock, and it took 45 minutes for an ambulance to come. And then he had a heart failure, and he was close to dying. After that whole story, somehow Sandra found out, and she called me and she said, "Why didn't you tell me?" And in a few weeks, we got this amazing, complete emergency medical equipment. The CFOIC did wonders. Thank you for coming and supporting us and knowing that there's people out there all over the world who care.
Susia, we are building a tree of life. In other words, the people here in Susia is a population, a small community, a population dedicated to Torah, to God, to the land of Israel. CFOIC is the link between this tree of life and the different Christian communities in the world. We have a mutual connection. That on one hand, we're blessed through the help, the financial aid, but much more important, much more significant, is also the blessing that the Christian community also receives through us, because this link connects every branch to the tree, and we have to be thankful to CFOIC for making that connection.
Thank you, CFOIC, for everything you've done for the Jordan Valley communities.
Thank you, Christian friends of Israeli communities, for your support for Kiryat Arba and Hebron.
Thank you, CFOIC, for everything you've done for Shani Livna.
Thank you, From Alephain.
Thank you very much, CFOIC, for the help to Efrat and the communities here in the area.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all you've done for Kochav Yaakov.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all you have done for Der Shalem.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all you have done for Dolev.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all you've done for Karnei Shomron.
Thank you, CFOIC, for everything you have done for Gdumim.
Thank you, CFOIC, for your support to Gilgal.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all the help you've given to Mitzpeh Hagit.
Thank you, CFOIC, for all of the wonderful help that you have given to the people of Gush Katif and to the people of Israel. Thank you.
sure.